I'm here to talk about my unplanned journey, something which I never planned. The only thing I did was I have stayed true and humble and loyal to whatever came in front of me, and I've responded in whichever way I could, and whatever talent I had, I used it. But the thing is that it has been totally unplanned, and I think the only message that I have for everyone here is never underestimate your the power of your emotion, and especially love. I will take you through my journey and how sometimes, you know, if you're creative, you actually put yourself in a lot of problems every time. You end up with a lot of problems. And how one problem has led me to another, and how I've survived. I will first dedicate this whole journey to my country. And I, there's a poet called Mohsin Naqvi. Mohsin Naqvi is a shayar. He speaks to himself when he's sitting. He says, "Chalo Mohsin, mohabbat ki nayi bunyad rakhte hain." You know, I hope all of you understand. "Chalo Mohsin, mohabbat ki nayi bunyad rakhte hain. Khud paband rehte hain, usse azad karte hain. Kahin is raste mein humse gustakhi na ho jaye, isliye hum apna har kadam uske kadam ke baad rakhte hain." This is a tribute to my country, and I did not know that, you know, when you talk about the context and the power of India, there's something called the soft power, and I did not know how I got hooked to the soft power of India, the power of culture, the power, the strength that we have in the context of the spirituality of India. And even though I left everything, I was the first one who would say that I want to leave Jammu and Kashmir forever and never return, and I exactly did that. But see, what happened to me is I responded, and I'm in the extreme edge of Jammu and Kashmir. I'm almost on the border of China, doing whatever I'm doing today. So today there's a lot of talk about India, and India, you know, people, when they're talking about the next superpower, you know, if it is the military strength, we have that. If it is population, we're going to talk the charts by 2034, superseding China. If it is the economy, we have that, and we are amongst the leading economies. It is not just these numbers. There's a lot of more to India, and it is the power of culture, the ability to attract people towards spirituality, yoga, Ayurveda. Today we're talking. The background of India in terms of, you know, India being the largest and the oldest civilization in the past 10,000 years, India has never invaded any country. Sanskrit is the mother of all European languages, things like that, you know, mathematics, trigonometry, zero, all of that comes from India. So I grew up with a background that in Kashmir, that time when I was growing up, the background was, you know, there was a lot of political and there was a lot of terrorism. Everyone at my age that time wanted to leave Jammu and Kashmir forever, and the only hope was if you're good academically, you can end up finding a good job, and that was the rope that would pull you out of Jammu and Kashmir, and you can hope for a better life. And I exactly did that. If you ask my friends, they say he's the guy who will leave Jammu and Kashmir and never return. I've been very passionate. I've been on the extremes in terms of what I wanted to do. I fell in love with technology. That time there was a dot-com boom and all of that, and people say that I was a hacker. I was actually a hacker, but I was actually in love with technology. I wanted to look at technology from a different perspective. In fact, that comes from anyone who's born and brought up in Jammu and Kashmir. You know, we've grown solving problems, and the problems are like, you know, finding grocery when there's a curfew and things like that. And you grow up and you solve problems. And when I got my first job, literally they had advertised they were looking for problem solvers, and it was very natural I would get picked because that is what I did all my life till that point.